Rahul Gandhi is firm on resigning as Congress president over the party's appalling performance in the election, even after his offer was unanimously rejected at a meeting on Saturday by top leaders. In fact, Priyanka Gandhi Vadra reportedly also asked her brother to give the party some time for an alternative plan. But Rahul also had some tough words for party leaders and chief ministers over them pushing their sons as party candidates and the party's dismal performance. Remember, chief ministers Ashok Gehlot and Kamal Nath, as well as senior leader Chidambaram, all had sons who fought this election. Let's go across to Sunil for more on that. Sunil, tell us more about what went on in that meeting.
Well, Gargi, it was a very interesting meeting. It was nearly 4.5 hours. And in that meeting, actually, what provoked and really made Rahul Gandhi respond was when Mr. Jyotiraditya was speaking, and it was in the backdrop of, you know, a culmination of senior Congress CWC members speaking about what went wrong, the reasons. And when he was talking about, you know, building local leaders, and he said, Jyotir, aren't you a state leader? And then went on to elaborate and respond to various points that the CWC meant. Members had pointed out after that meeting to say very categorically that look here, you know, looking at you know, people like Mr. Gehlot, looking at Mr. Chidambaram, then referring about the fact that you know, it's either me or the party, either my son or the party. It's in that context that Rahul Gandhi responded. So he didn't take anybody's name per se, but was responding and saying that. We haven't we built state leaders like Mr. Ashok Gehlot, or for that matter, Bhupesh Baghel. Somewhere down the line, the chief ministers weren't able to deliver in any of those three states, crucial states, which they won in less than 6 months earlier. And it's in that context that Rahul Gandhi was searching for questions and answers, and made it very categorically clear to that CWC, Gargi, that he will not sit on that president's chair. It's then that people like Mr. P. Chidambaram broke down into tears, saying that the people of South India, in particular Tamil Nadu, love him, and it will be very, very wrong if he steps down. How would we answer people who attempt to commit suicide? These are the points. I mean, it was extremely emotional and extremely plain speak by Rahul Gandhi in terms of what was the reason for why the Congress did badly, the polarization, a number of other aspects. But I think both his mother, Sonia Gandhi, the former Congress president, made it clear that we have to respect Rahul Gandhi's decision, and she couldn't really intervene in this matter in terms of finding a way forward. And Priyanka Gandhi also arguing that, you know, this is the Congress working committee. We need to give it time. We shouldn't be in a hurry. Let a plan B come in. But Mr. Rahul Gandhi is adamant, as we broke that story yesterday, is insisting on resigning, Gargi, right. And clearly the Congress Working Committee will take a few days to come to terms with it, but definitely they will have to find a new Congress president.
All right, so Sunil, very interesting details, you know, about him hitting out at senior leaders about you know, compromising on the party's performance, pushing their sons, and now with the, you know, Priyanka Gandhi Vadra saying that the party needs more time, is it too soon to, you know, have you heard anything about alternatives, any names, anything that we can, you know, report right now?
Well, I think they're still coming to terms with it. They're still in a state of denial within the Congress party. They're not ready to accept the fact that Rahul Gandhi will step down. But those who know Rahul Gandhi and those who understand what he believes in, he's quite determined, and they will have to come to terms with the fact that he is not going to continue as Congress president. He's quite clear in his mind about what he sees as the future. It's not that, and he made that very categorically clear at the Congress Working Committee, Gargi. He's not vanishing, he's not escaping, he's not running away. He will continue to fight the BJP and the RSS, but definitely it has to be in a new space, in a new platform. What that platform is, whether he'll remain as the parliamentary party leader, which could be something that he avoided the last time round, or will it be in a different capacity? That's a call that will be taken. But as I said, it's too soon to decide on who will be a replacement, because for people like me who have covered the Congress when Narasimha Rao was asked, decided to quit as Congress president, at that time the name of Mr. A.K. Anthony came up. Subsequently, it was Mr. Sitaram Kesri who ultimately became the Congress president. So it's in that backdrop that they will have to start the deliberations, but definitely the Congress party will have to start that search exercise of who would be able to take on the mantle.